Now, three new features in Excel. And the big one is less F9 escape in the formula bar. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. I'm going to show you three different things today. The AutoSave icon moves from the quick access toolbar to words in the title. Personalized toolbar is in preview. And then the one that I think is really good is this new thing they're calling value preview. It's like pressing F9 in the formula bar, but on hover. Let's start with that one. Okay, so here is a formula. And of course, up here in the formula bar, we can see the formula. But the thing that's different now is if I would select any bit of that formula with the mouse and then hover, they'll show me that the month of today is one. And that's right, it's January. So it's the first month. And we can actually, like anywhere inside the index, we can just click on array and it'll show us that item. So, and then what's the row number? The row number is one. It's pretty cool. You know, of course, if you watch Excel is Fun, he always shows us this trick where he presses F9, but then has to remember to press escape to go back to the original formula. Now we won't have to do that anymore. We can just simply hover and it'll work. Now, this is version one. And of course, the very first formula that I pulled up, because I'm working on it for another video, was something that would generate a date. And unfortunately, when we generate a date, it's giving us the serial number instead of the date itself. And I said to Steve on the Excel team, I said, hey, you know, any chance that could be a date? He's like, well, yeah, but it's complicated. You know, how are we going to show the date? Is it your default date in your local format? He says, we understand we want to get there, but we're not sure what date is the right date to show. And I get it, right? I mean, it's more complicated than just show us a date. So they're certainly aware of that. You can click any cell there, so 44962. I can click the holiday range. See, I have to get used to this. The tooltip is right here. It would have been easier just to click on end date and then holidays rather than trying to scoop it out using the formula bar. So this is something we'll get used to. It's pretty cool. I tried it on an array, so we have an array here, so sequence of 4224, and they'll show me, and even in the array formula nomenclature there, where a comma means go to the next column and a semicolon means go to the next row. Here I have an X lookup, and once I click inside the X lookup, I can click on each item in the tooltip. So the lookup value is fig, the lookup array is those items, the return array is these items. All right, so it's cool. It's cool over here. We have an if function, click inside the if. I can just click on the logical test. If I need to see what today is, the serial number for today is 44952. Now, what if you select like part of something like ODA? They have no clue, like what are you talking about? You know, we don't know what that means. It's also possible to do, here, let's do a strange one. Let's do equal 301 plus 12345. And I will select 301 plus 12. And it will evaluate that part. Now F9, I don't think F9, what would F9 do? Oh yeah, F9 would do it too. Okay, so, you know, I guess it kind of acts just like F9. So, you know, to me that seems kind of like a bit of a silly one. Just be aware that it's there, right? So I think this arrived yesterday for Insiders Fast. I had to do the update to get it and it's probably rolled out to 50% of the people. So it's one of these things that's coming. I really like it. I can't wait to hear what Excel is Fun has to say because he uses this method constantly and hopefully he will love that. All right, next one. This seems really small to me. You know, back last week and even on my laptop, AutoSave is, you know, this isn't actually part of the quick access toolbar, is it? That everything to the left of that vertical bar. And AutoSave was taking up a lot of space up there with an icon to show whether it was on or off. I mean, they removed that now by default. And where have they moved it? They moved it up here to the title bar. So there's the title bar. And at the end, they show you if autosave is off or on. And then in this little drop down here, you know, that they tell me, well, hey, if you want to use autosave, you need to upload your document to the cloud. And then we can see the toggle if it's on or off. If we right click and customize quick access toolbar, is autosave available to bring it back in case you like it there? It looks like no. You know, this one's going to drive you crazy a little bit if you use this a lot. I never autosave, so I don't look there. It's going to take some getting used to instead of looking up here in the top left to look all the way over here on the right. But you'll get used to it. Why did they do this? My theory is that they're introducing this thing called a personalized toolbar. Right now, I have two computers here on my desk. Neither of these have this, but my teaching laptop, when I go do a PowerExcel seminar, I pull that teaching laptop out and it has it, right? So we get this little notifier, a toolbar just for you. Welcome to a more personalized office experience. We will create a toolbar just for you, which contains your most frequently used commands for quick and easy access. You can still view the classic ribbon whenever you want. All right, so I said, you know, sure, yeah, try it. The great news is you can switch back. And of course, on that day, I was like leaving for class. I couldn't bother to look at it, but I looked at it today and we'll take a look. And then you can re-expand the ribbon by clicking any tab, right-click any action to add it to your new toolbar. So we can add new things to the toolbar. Okay, so here's a look at the personalized toolbar on my laptop. And of course, on my laptop, I'm signed in as Bill Jelen, so it's the same account. I'm fairly convinced that when they looked at what I'm doing a lot, they're looking at all of the machines, like insert shape and insert screen clipping and shape quick styles. Those are all things I do when I'm doing a podcast, and I never do a podcast from the laptop, right? So these are things, yes, I do these a lot, but I do it on the desktop, and it's interesting that it showed up on the laptop. That might be a great feature if they were that clever to do it. All right, here's all of the things that I had on the Quick Access Toolbar and all of these things that are lost, right? So these are things that I think that I do a lot, but they don't perceive that I do it a lot. And then the other thing you'll notice is that when this toolbar is shown, the ribbon is automatically minimized, right? So, you know, I started to look at these items right here, this whole group right here. Wow, I do these a lot, I said, but I don't need them on the Quick Access Toolbar because they're right here available to me on the Home tab. Like I don't take things from my Home tab and add them to the Quick Access Toolbar, but now that the ribbon is collapsed by default, they had to add these back. Pivot table, yep, certainly do those a lot, but you know, I don't mind going to the Insert tab, Insert picture, Insert shape, Screen clipping. This one, the Print area group, to set or clear the print area, I'm constantly doing set print area, never doing clear print area. So it's a little weird that they chose the whole group instead of set print area. Yeah. And then, okay, for those of us who are just gonna reject this and just use the Quick Access Toolbar, a couple things you'll notice. First off, right click, see I can customize the Quick Access Toolbar. I can show above or below the ribbon, and I can choose, if I go below the ribbon, then I can hide or show command labels. All right, all of that UI has been moved. When you right click now on the new Quick Access Toolbar, after you get this custom toolbar, when you right click on the Quick Access Toolbar, all you have is either remove or customize. And then once you go into Excel options, the customize, that's where they say toolbar position above or below, always show command labels. And then later I also found that if you go to that little drop down at the far right side of the ribbon, that they've moved above or below there as well. See, it's not there in the old way, the new way, once you have the personal toolbar. So they move some things around, which even if you just reject the personal toolbar, is going to, you know, cause a little bit of adjustment for you. I can add things to the personal toolbar, right? So I added the filter just to see, because they added the sort and filter group, which, you know, like now I have two clicks to get to it. So I just added filters. But the one thing I can't seem to do is in this personal toolbar, I can't move things around. I can't move them left or right. Like for example, a sort dialog is here, which is quite a way from the sort and filter group. And that's probably because this is on home and this is on data. They've organized it in the same order as the ribbon that they're trying to simplify. All right, so there we are. You know, I think the big news today is this replacement for F9 in the formula bar. That's the one that a lot of people, I think, will be able to use and really like. The autosave is gonna take some getting used to, but I'll get used to it. And then this new personal toolbar, you know, it's just gonna have to, they're going to have to notify you on a day when you have nothing else to do and you can actually take a look at it and see what will work better for you. You know, for me, I'm probably just going to keep using the Quick Access Toolbar because, you know, like I say, there's a lot of things, you know, I've customize my quick access toolbar to show things that I use a lot that aren't in the ribbon, right? You know, and like these things that aren't in the ribbon, subscript and superscript, you know, how would I ever get those back? Like, I don't know how I could right click on something that's not there to say add to the custom toolbar. So this is interesting. And it's also interesting that this one only appeared on one of three laptops, and everyone I've talked to who does not have this yet. So maybe this is only rolled out, you know, what, 1%, 5%? So they're probably doing some, you know, testing to see what the reaction is before they roll this one out wider. All right, there you go. That was me, three quick tips. I think one really good one that I'm excited to use, and then two others that I will, well, in one case get used to, and the other case probably turn off for right now. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.